I haven't had the pleasure to meet him, Father George Elliott. And I just want to extend my sincerest condolences to Jennifer and Jacob and all of the family at the passing of Jimmy. I had the pleasure of getting out and visiting him for a bit before he passed, and he was definitely a colorful man, as the world would be a little less bright. Please stand. Begin all things in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Jimmy died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. My brothers and sisters, we've come together to renew our trust in Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death, and by rising has opened for us the gates of heaven. Let us pray for our brother, that he may share in Christ's victory, and let us pray for ourselves, that the Lord may grant the gift of his loving consolation. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Jimmy, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of Job. I know that my Redeemer lives. Job answered and said, "Oh, would that my words were written down. Would that they were inscribed in a record, that with an iron chisel and with lead they were cut in the rock forever. But as for me, I know that my Vindicator lives, and that he will at last stand forth upon the dust, whom I myself shall see, my own eyes, not another's, shall behold him. And from my flesh I shall see God. My inmost being is consumed with longing. This is the word of God."
Thanks be to God. Please stand for the gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jews, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life and will not come to condemnation, but is passed from death to life. Amen, amen, I say to you, the hour is coming and is now here when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so also he gave to his Son possession of life in himself. And he gave him power to exercise judgment, because he is the Son of Man. Do not be amazed at this, because the hour is coming in which all who are in the tombs will hear his voice and will come out. Those who have done good deeds to the resurrection of life, but those who have done wicked deeds to the resurrection of condemnation." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Nobody here, none of us, thus far, have passed the gates of death. And none of us have died as of yet. But we share that one thing with all of humanity, that we're all going to be there eventually. The beautiful thing with Jimmy's passing is that he was a man that was not unaccustomed to death. You know, every single one of us had a certain fear of what might come at that moment, but for a man like Jimmy, between his faith and the life that he lived, he'd become, in a certain sense, comfortable with death. He didn't want it, but he knew it was coming. First off, we have great hope for Jimmy, that he was baptized into Jesus Christ. In a certain sense, we could say he's already died. Because in baptism, we die with Christ to rise with him, to live a new life. And so, When it comes to our bodily death, our earthly death that Jimmy has passed through, we can all say, you know, oh death, where is your victory? Oh death, where is your sting? We've already been here. We've already done this. And beyond that, Jimmy was a man that lived a hard life. He served his country in the military. And I won't use the colorful words that he used to describe his military experience, but it was fast, I'll say. He's a man who had seen death before and knew that it was not the end. He had made great sacrifice in himself, and also he had watched others make that ultimate sacrifice. So he was a man who had spent his life serving. That gives us also great hope for Jimmy, that this is not the end. That God, in his great mercy, who made himself a servant, who came to serve and not to be served, will look upon Jimmy and see, I see my image in you. I made you as a human being in my image and likeness, and you responded by your life to live as I did, as a true servant. You could almost even say that Jimmy lived that servanthood to a fault. And there were plenty of people that took advantage of him. And while he was a fighter, he made it, you know? He was able to still, in his own way, love those people and keep giving of himself. Most of us, when we get burned a few times, we say, that's it, I'm done. I'm never doing this again. And I put up my guard, nobody's ever getting in. And Jimmy was the kind of man that chose to still continue to give of himself throughout his entire life. It's a real, real heroic humility in his own way. And so, I want to encourage everybody to continue to pray for Jimmy. As you all know, when we die, we come before the face of God, and our eternal destiny is decided. And God, who is a merciful Father, is also a just judge. None of us are perfect. All of us have sinned. And so, we now should dedicate ourselves to praying for Jimmy, that our Lord will look upon him and see his own image in that brother of ours, and who look upon him and say, well done, my good and faithful servant. Enter into the kingdom prepared for you from all eternity. Please stand. God the Almighty Father raised Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. And the response is, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer. For Jimmy, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For our brother, who gave of himself in service, that our Lord may look at him as a true and humble servant, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the family and friends of our brother Jimmy, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. as Christ the Lord has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul, and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul, and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul, and present him to God the Most High.
To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Jimmy, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In peace, let us take our brother into his place of rest. Please be seated.
Celebrating the life of my dad. A week ago today, my daddy left his earthly home to join his forever home in heaven with Jesus. I know he was welcomed with open arms by his parents, his beloved brother J.K., and many friends that he has lost over the years. But of course, they want to ask why. But I've concluded that God needed an angel with Daddy's attitude and skill set. And boy, did he have an attitude. As some of you know, my daddy served in the U.S. Army. He was in the 82nd Airborne Division, which was part of the 173rd Airborne Brigade. They were called Sky Soldiers. Probably back then, I would have probably called them Sky Angels. They parachuted into the major communist areas of Vietnam. He had a nickname named Mouse. I don't know why they called him Mouse. Apparently he was quiet back then, he said, but we know Jimmy Mon is not to be quiet. He told me many stories along our drives. And he had a hard time telling the stories. He didn't tell the stories for a long time when he came back. But every once in a while he would talk about it. I never brought up the subject. And then I would listen to him. And he would talk about his friends and things that happened over there, which haunted him for many, many years. I don't think he ever got over that. And I think he finally And his last days, we talked about it, and I think he made peace with that. My dad was awarded 2 Bronze Star medals for heroism, but he didn't consider himself a hero. But we all know he was a hero. To me, any man or woman who dedicates and enrolls and listening in top of military, to me, is a hero. So I'll honor anyone in this room that has ever served in the military or currently serving. I thank you for your service. Daddy lived his life with the same creed. If he trusted you and called you his friend, then he would do anything for you. Most of NACA coaches knew my dad. Some of the game wardens, sheriff's departments. I've heard a lot of stories over the last few weeks as friends would come to visit. And boy, were they funny. One that my husband and I would talk about, he had went, him and my cousin Scotty went with some of their friends over to a friend's house, and they were talking about one night. My daddy wanted to go hunting. And they went out to the golf course and went hunting. I won't name any names, I promise. And that's a different story. I'm going to miss our road trips. My backseat driver. He was always complaining of how I drove. Every time I look in my windshield, and make sure it's clean. Sometimes he would flip people off if they pulled out in front of me, which was quite often, because he had bad road rage. When I would drop him off from our trips or wherever we went to have lunch or whatnot, I would tell him, I'd say, "Oh, you behave, Daddy. Don't you go get in any trouble." He's saying, "I ain't gonna get in no trouble." My daddy was a very simple man. He had a flip phone. He still had an address book with all of his friends' phone numbers in it. Only carried cash. He never would carry a debit card or a checkbook. I asked him one time, I said, "Don't you want to get a debit card? Then you don't have to go into the stores and pay." "I don't want one of them darn gift cards, debit cards." Of course, I'm sugarcoating a little bit. One time I told him, I was like, "I think you need to get a recliner for your living room, Daddy." I said, "That way you can relax and sit back and watch your westerns." And he said, he looked at me and said, "What's wrong with my plastic lawn chairs I got in the living room?" He said, "You got a lot of plastic lawn chairs?" I said, "No, they're fine." He loved my girls. He thought my girls were good. And he loved family. And he loved his friends so much. We talked about all of his friends. And I know I don't know all your names, but I know over the years that if I met you and I know your name, I would, after I would leave or call him or talk to him on the phone, I'd say, "Okay, Daddy, I'll talk to you. I'll call you later." And he said, "Well, call me something nice." But I love my daddy so much. My husband. None of us are perfect. We all have demons. But he pushed through those. But let me leave you with this. And do not wait until the next funeral to wish he had visited more, or talked more, or forgiven more freely. Because life is short, but it's beautiful. And when you know Jesus, it's truly not just goodbye, but it's saving his seat. And then I won't see my daddy. But I'm as proud of the man he was. And I loved him, and I know he loved me very much. Thank you for coming. Thank you.
Jennifer for letting me share some memories of that. And on behalf of the family, thanks everyone that's here for that. We appreciate it. My name's Lewis Thumb. I'm the eldest nephew, maybe the favorite. Not Scotty. Nathan. We'll leave that alone. Uncle Jimmy had a lot of nicknames. I know his legal name is Jimmy Edward Montes. Grandma Bonnie used to affectionately refer to him as Buddy. And I found out today that was because Aunt Diane couldn't pronounce his name when she was very young. And she would call him Buddy, so it stuck with Grandma Bonnie. She continued that through our life. Myself, Wendy, Scotty, Kelly, Nathan, Susanna, and Benjamin, we all, and Farrah, we used to all call him Uncle Jimmy. And I'm sure a lot of you here today refer to him as Catfish. That was a pretty common reference to him. But then once my daughters were born, around our house, he was known as Uncle Catfish. So, man of many names. And over the past week, I've reminisced and thought about him a lot. And quotes and memories, and some of the quotes I'd like to share is he used to use the term Bubba Louie. And that was to refer to a friend, an affectionate term for